of the organizer was, another, he has requested that that person also should be allowed and two, three very brief questions. Yes, you can put forward your question, brother.
My name is Manoj Raicha. My first question is, under the name Universal Brotherhood, you are advertising Islam, and on the basis of that, please define your terms when you are saying that Universal Brotherhood. You should, under the name Universal Brotherhood, you should accept brotherhood to all, whether Muslims, that is follower of Islam, and non-Muslims, which you say kafir, who don't. Otherwise, quote the term Muslim Brotherhood, it will be okay.
The brother asked a question that in the name of Universal Brotherhood, I am promoting Islam. Suppose if I have to say that, you know, best cloth, I am promoting best cloth in market. And suppose raiment has to be the best cloth. So it's a fact I am promoting raiments. If raiments company is best, anyway, I don't get any cut from raiments. That's an example. I'm not a dealer of raiments. But if I say the best cloth is raiment, and if the talk is which is the best cloth, I have to speak about that. Suppose I'm giving a talk on who is the best doctor in the world. And if I have to take a person named XYZ, and if he's the best doctor, I'm promoting him, yes. So similarly, Universal Brotherhood, I'm telling you that Islam is a religion which speaks about Universal Brotherhood and shows you a way how to achieve it. Regarding a question, that in Universal Brotherhood, can you call Muslim and non-Muslim as brother, or only Muslims as brothers? The Universal Brotherhood of Islam is all human beings are your brothers. I made it very clear in my talk. I'm not mincing with words. I'm very clear. Maybe it may have slipped. You may not have heard it. I started my talk. It's for Hujurat, chapter 49, verse 13. Ya ayyuha an-nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu inna akramakum indallahi atqakum innallaha alimun khabir. That, oh humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female, and have divided you into nations and tribes so that you shall recognize each other, not that you shall despise each other. And the most honored in the sight of Allah is the person who has taqwa, who has righteousness, who has piety, who has God consciousness. In the Universal Brotherhood are all human beings. The person who has got piety is one who has taqwa or righteousness. I've got two brothers. One is a good person. Actually, I've got one brother only. But suppose I have two brothers. One is a medical doctor like this brother and is treating the patient, etc., cure. And the other brother is a drunkard, is a rapist. Both are my brothers. Who is a better brother? A brother who is a doctor and treats the people and doesn't cause harm to the society. The other brother is my brother, but he's not a good brother of mine. Similarly, all human beings are my brothers. But those who are closer to me are those who have taqwa, who has righteousness, who has piety. Anyone who has piety, who has righteousness, who has God consciousness, is closer to me. It's very clear. I've said my talk and I repeat it. Hope that answers the question.
Connected?
You have differentiated Hinduism, Islamic and Christianity. In all three religions, there are good things for brotherhood. You have not explained brotherhood in Hinduism, brotherhood in Christianity.
The brother said that I have spoken good things about Islam, Universal Brotherhood. I haven't spoken good things about Hinduism and Christianity. I did speak certain good things. I didn't speak everything about brotherhood in Hinduism and Christianity because people may not be able to digest it here. This is what I'm saying, people can't digest. I have to be patient. I know Christianity, I have studied the Bible, I have studied the Hindu scriptures. If I speak on that, I'm not here to create a rift. What I'm here to talk about the commonalities. So what is common I spoke? Hinduism says don't rob, Christianity says don't rob, don't molest, don't rape, fine. Other things on brotherhood. Do you know, just a sample I'm giving you. Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, said, it's mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 10, verse number 5 to 6. It says, I'm quoting, chapter number, verse number, quoting, there's no two doubts about it. He told the apostles that go ye not into the way of the Gentiles, but rather go to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. Who are the Gentiles? The non-Jews, the Hindus, the Christians, we are the Gentiles. Don't throw pearls before pigs. He calls us as pigs. Am I going to speak about that? Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, says in the Gospel of Matthew, chapter number 15, verse number 24, he says that I have not been sent but to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. I'm quoting chapter number, verse number. So this means that that religion is only meant for the Jews, not for the whole universe. In other religions, they believe in monasticism. In monasticism. If you have to come closer to God, you have to renounce the world. You have to renounce the world. Most of the major religions. Hinduism says that, Christianity says that. To come closer to God, you have to renounce the world. Quran says in Surah Hadith, chapter 57, verse number 27, that it's against monasticism. Monasticism is not allowed in Islam. Our beloved Prophet said, there's no monasticism. It's mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, volume number 7, in the book of Nikah, chapter number 3, hadith number 4. Oh, young people, whoever has the means to get married should get married. Hadith says that. If I agree that if you renounce the world, you come closer to Almighty God, and if every human being renounces the world today, then within a span of 100 to 150 years, there will not be a single human being alive in this world. If everyone practices this law throughout the world, where is the universal brotherhood? Therefore, brother, I am only come to talk about the good points. Unless you want to have knowledge about other religions, it's my job. I have to speak the truth. Quran says in Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 81, وَقُلْ جَالْ حَقّْ وَزَاقَ الْبَاطِلِ إِنَّ الْبَاطِلَ كَانَ ذَهُوكَ. When truth is heard against falsehood, falsehood perishes. For falsehood is by its nature bound to perish. Hope that answers the question.